Hey guys, what's up? And I want to talk to you guys about the Avatar Legend of Korra. Now, I've watched the Avatar, the last Airbender and Legend of Korra growing up ever since I was young and up until like 2014, 2013 of when it finally ended, if not before that. I want to talk to you about where I think they missed up. Well, they messed up and missed an opportunity to capitalize and keep this show going and make it more, you know, more interesting. One point I want to point out is the un-avatar is what they call it, or Mvatu. I call him Mvatu. He is the opposite of Rava. Everybody knows Rava is. She's the one that was there since the beginning. She's basically the avatar state. And, you know, she barely ever talks. She's only talked to Korra and Avatar Wan, the first one. So what I think they should have done with that is just simply keep them around. If they'd have just kept them around a little bit longer, or not even a little bit longer, kept them around indefinitely, because after all the other bosses and boss modes that Korra's went through and beat, there's really... I mean, even those, like the later two bosses that she beat, they just felt so stale. They have had an opportunity to keep this guy, you know, alive and go into the future and have him reincarnate as somebody who, you know, Korra has to stop. Like, you can't tell me that's not interesting, having somebody that Korra, or not Korra, but the other avatar after her has to stop. Like, make it even playing ground. Maybe he reincarnated somebody and Rava reincarnated somebody. Like, that would be so good. But instead, because you can't get rid of him. He's light and dark. They can't exist without each other. That would be so good. But they missed a big opportunity. Instead, they locked him away once again. Like, look at it. Why introduce him, then get rid of him? Oh, my gosh. Unless they just didn't care anymore and just wanted to wrap it up. But from sources, and like I've heard of sources saying that they want to bring it back. Well, you missed a great opportunity unless you're going to release him back and make it into the future where it's, you know, he's an avatar and he's the anti-avatar and they're fighting together in different reincarnations. That's the only way I see anything coming good of this. I just think about that. And another point, I know it's years later and people's probably not talking about this anymore. But simply, why sever history? You probably didn't care anymore because of the new generation that was watching it. But a lot of us fans kept with the show. And that really hurt us to see that all that history that they Aang had since Avatar Wan is now gone. It's just despicable. Maybe they were thinking because they exposed us to the first Avatar, nothing else was needed. But no, there was countless others we could have learned from. But if you agree, disagree, feel free to leave your comment down in the description. Leave a like and subscribe for more. Thanks. I'm out. I'm doing my rant.